You know, I go to Africa a good bit, and there came an opportunity to take somewhere else this year, and red popped right in my head. You know, we didn't have any intention on doing a Buckshot Red funny show, but anywhere he goes with us, it turns into that.
John and Red have been, I would say, best friends since at least high school.
Yeah, we grew up together, went to high school, played football together and everything. We're pretty good friends.
Red is probably the best friend that I have in my life. And you sit there and you can say, well, you know, how can you pick on your best friend all your life? But the one thing that I'll say, if I'm not picking on Red, Red is absolutely miserable.
I mean, it's like John says, if he doesn't pick on you, then he doesn't like you.
But he's a good friend. I love him like a brother.
You know, Red sometimes speaks in a different language, so we tried to spell it out for you a little bit to help you better understand him.
Good morning, folks. Buckshot Red. We are hunting at Bushman Safari in South Africa. And we got Brandy Wilson right here. Like, really looking a hunter today. And we're going to be shooting us some warthog. Stay tuned.
My first day sitting in the blind, I saw a bunch of animals. I have never seen so many animals. I'm from Georgia, and I have never seen that many animals. One of the animals that was on my list was an impala. Impala come out, I got my bow and got ready.
Man, I killed my first blast bug, man. Excited to get your faces.
I meant to say impala.
God, man, my first kill in Africa. With my PSE. Whoa.
Yeah, when I shot my impala, I was kind of shaking and everything. John said, why are you shaking? Well, that's my first time I ever shot a bow, and the first time I ever been to Africa.
Find my error.
I would say that looks like a miss to me. Completely screwed up miss. Huh? The way to test it now, the way to test it. The only way to test it, you do that. How does it taste?
Listen, yeah. He had so many animals. Y'all listen to this. He could shoot at, and he was so. You could just hear his heartbeat. He had a Gims welt right there. I said, no. Because you could just tell. He was just, he couldn't breathe.
The tracker gave me the shirt. They said, we quit. Here, you track it. I had to put the shirt on, track my own impala.
Here's messed up right here.
There he is laying right there.
What?
Yeah. Good, gracious alive.
Woo! Congratulations, Bob.
Good tracking, man. Thank good
you.
Tracking.
Thank you, definitely.
My first kill in Africa.
This is your first barbecue, man. Yeah.
First kill.
I just want to say congratulations, my friend.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
What a privilege to have you here on this.
Thank you. Thank you.
hope you'll let me come back.
You know, I have to say I was definitely proud of my boy on his Impala.
We was there at the lodge. When you make a shot, a good shot and everything, when you kill something, it's the tradition over there. They give these balls out. Okay? When I shot my Impala, I got the balls.
Well, tonight it's a privilege to present this trophy, man of the match, man of the moment, to Mr. Redmond McQuinna. Congratulations, my friend.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell us what happened?
Man, I tell you what, he came in and I thought I did a bad shot, but I got both of his lungs.
Good, good.
What did you shoot? What did you shoot?
An Impala.
At where were you?
Stay there and talk. You got business for TV.
I shot it at
Bushman Safaris.
If you are a bow hunter and you are considering Africa, Bushman Safaris pays more attention to detail for the bow hunter than I've ever seen any operation in my entire life. You know, Bushman Safaris has been bow-only since 1986. It was the first bow-only operation in South Africa. And, you know, wanted to show you around and show you the accommodations, so who better do it than Buckshot Red? Red, yes. You know, Bushman Safaris gave us this hunt, mm-hmm. You know, for us to promote them on television and you know, to do this veteran hunt and everything. And, you know, one of the shows kind of is about you. Mm-hmm. So what I need you to do in your show is I need you to take everybody on a tour of this entire facility, because, you know, if they see this facility and see how nice it is, they'll want to come hunting here and they'll call Bushman and book a hunt. So, you know, go all around, show everything about the rooms, the lodge, where you eat and everything. Just take them on a tour.
Okay. Right now we are coming up to where we practice shooting bows. You got a lower part you can shoot at, and you got an upper part you can shoot at. That target, you got a bat ground thing right there where you tip, you catch your arrows. And these are the vehicles that we go out hunting on. They're nice vehicles. All right, here we got the swimming pool. This thing right here, man, I tell you what, for being out here on hunting, come back in and get you a dip and pool. It's good. Right here is where we eat supper at night. We got the bar for refreshments and everything. They treat you like you at home. Right here is a tiger that Nick killed.
Tiger?
Yeah, that's a lion.
Ain't no tiger.
That's a lion.
They don't have tigers.
That's a lion.
Then why'd you say tiger?
I don't know why I said tiger. That's a lion.
Keep going.
This is a blessed buck.
That is a red hearted beast.
That's a red hearted beast. Okay, excuse me, red hearted beast.
You gotta show them all that.
That's a, I don't know, it looked like a miniature deer. This is a kudu. This is what I was calling my wildebeest yesterday. I was calling it a kudu. That's another little bitty animal. I can't think of the name of it. This is a red buck. Right here is my, this is where you stay at, the room and everything. Mm-hmm. And this is where you stay. And it's nice. You got the bathroom and the shower and everything. Bottom line, Bushman Safaris is the best place to stay.
This was my first trip to Africa, and it was a welcome break from my normal day-to-day activities. I also got to spend some quality time with my husband, doing things that he does on a day-to-day basis. Today we're at the Zebra Blind again, and it looks like it's going to be a good sunny day, so maybe we'll see a lot of animals come in. The rain seems like it's gone, so all we can do is hope. While we were sitting in the blinds, we saw so many animals. It's just unbelievable. I saw animals that I had never even heard of, and I mean, they would just come in, and I would ask John. I would be like, "What animal is that? What animal is that?" And he would be telling me to be quiet. Whenever I released that arrow, I was so nervous because the wildebeest just jumped and ran off, and the first thought that went through my head is, I just made a bad shot.
We just found an arrow and the penetration was better than what we thought. We're gonna keep looking.
You know, when Brandy shot her wildebeest, she, you know, don't let her fool you, she was real excited also. You know, the wildebeest turned a little bit. She hit it kind of in the shoulder. And, you know, with her not shooting the poundage that some of us guys are, we were a little bit worried. But we went out of the blind. The trackers came in. They jumped on the blood. And, you know, we had a little walk, but dead as a doornail.
This is what they call the poor man, in your case, woman, buffalo. If you can't afford a Cape buffalo, then you shoot a wildebeest. And we didn't have to track it very far. But that ram cat put it down.
No, for real. Like, after I shot it, I went like this to the camera. I was like, did it die? Did I hit it good? And John was like, I don't know. I acted excited. And I was like, I can't. Did it die? And he was like, I don't know. Smile. And I was like, did it die?
Red shot an animal previously, and he didn't want me to go anywhere with him anymore. He's an experienced hunter. You'd have thought he's been hunting in Africa 100 times. So I went with Brandy, and Red just kind of kicked me to the curb.
Well, I was hunting with John, and all of a sudden I said, "Well, shoot!" I said, "I want to go by myself because I think I'm a better hunter than John." It was kind of slow. It was probably around lunch. Well, the beast come in, I got my bow, I was ready.
There it goes. Bloop. He's dead. Yeah, he's dead, man. I just killed me, I will at least. I saw a guy dropping hit probably about 20 yards right here. But I hit dead in the heart. Where Shannon told me to shoot.
Awesome shot.
Man, I'm ready to go see you. I'm ready to go see you. Shot a kudu, he's down over here. I shot a
What's it called?
Damn blend.
Huh?
I shot a Willabeast.
A what?
A Willabeast.
Wildabeast. Say it right though.
Wildabeast.
No.
Willabeast.
Wildabeast.
Willabeast.
Wild with a D.
Will. Will a D. Willabeast. Willabeast.
No, Red, come here.
Hello, man. I'm so excited to get over here.
All right. Now, what'd you shoot? Come on, walk with me.
I shot a wildebeest. Yeah. He's right over here.
Let's go get him.
Let's go get him. That's pretty. God, that's pretty. God, that is beautiful. When I shot the wildebeest, I call it the kudu. I was so excited, my adrenaline was kicking in. I couldn't talk. Yeah, I shot this at, I got this round this afternoon, about 4 o'clock this afternoon. This wildebeest come out and put the arrow where I need to put him at. I said, I put the arrow where I need to put him at. Got him at the Bushman Safaris.
So Red, congratulations, my friend.
Yes, sir.
Very good shot.
Yes.
Just where you need it.
Yes, sir.
Just tell me what happened.
He came in and I could say, you nervous? I said, nah, I ain't nervous. I said, I get it. I could see he had his bow full back just in case I did miss. But he said I had to put word of money word to date. I guess to take practice. My son Shannon, he helped me.
But then I believe John said he's going to shoulder mount it for you also.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay.
Good man.
Thank you for having me.
Oh yeah.
What do you gotta say to John right now?
Eat your heart out, bud. What you kill?
Ah, it's time for the thing, you know? Well, it can only be one guy tonight. Sir, sorry, but not you. Red Riding Hood, come, man.
Big Red.
Red got the ball twice. Yay!
But not only that. For the best shot, the safari, we give you the golden one.
Oh!
Oh,
you
got a set of balls.
Yeah, come on, buddy.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations. Good shot, man.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations, Ren.
Hey, appreciate
it. Speech.
Yeah.
Speech, Ren.
Okay, speech. Tell us how thankful you are and all that kind of
well,
stuff.
Well, I tell you what. Man, this is, I tell you what, this is the best time I ever had in my life.
Good.
And, I mean, that's the first time I ever been to Africa, and shoot, thanks, John. Hope you let me come back, Nick.
Well,
you didn't even pick on me when he smiled. I was fixing to climb in on him. I was like, oh, man, I can't do that.
Well, we're happy to be part of it.
Yeah.
And we enjoy it,
mm-hmm.
And we tease you, we all tease you, but because we like you, man.
Yeah.
You know, good times with friends and family like we had in Africa at Bushman Safaris, that's what the outdoors is all about.